takes a lot of men to make a gun. Hundreds, many men to make a gun. Men in the mines to dig the iron, men in the mills to forge the steel, men at machines to turn the barrel, mold the trigger, shape the wheel. It takes a lot of men to make a gun. One gun,
and all you have to do is move your little finger, move your little finger, and you can change the world. Why should you be blue when you've your little finger? Prove how just a little finger can change the world.
What a wonder is a gun. What a versatile invention. First of all, when you've a gun, everybody pays attention. When you think what must be done, think of all that it can do. Remove a scoundrel, unite a party, preserve the union, promote the sales of my book, ensure my future, my niche in history, and then the world will see that I am not a man to overlook. Ha-ha!
And all you have to do is squeeze your little finger, ease your little finger back. You can change the world. Whatever else is true, you trust your little finger. Just a single little finger can change the world.
I got this really great gun. Shit, where is it? No, it's really great. Wait, shit, where is it? Anyway, it's just a 38. But it's a gun. You can make a statement. Wrong with a gun, even if you fail. It tells them who you are, where you stand. This one was on sale. It, no, not the shoe. Well, actually, the shoe was too. No, that's not it. Shit, I had it here. Got it. Yeah, there it is.
And all you have to do is crook your little finger, hook your little finger around.
Shit, I shot it.
You can change the world. Follow through and look, your little finger can
slow them down
to a crawl, show them all,
big and small. It took a little finger no time to change the
many men before it's done. Hundreds, long before you shoot the gun. Men in the mines and in the steel mills, men at machines who died for what? Something to buy? A watch, a shoe, a gun, a thing to make the bosses richer. But a gun claims many men before it's done. Just one.
Joel Gosh, working man, born in the middle of Michigan, woke with a thought and away he ran to the Pan American Exposition in Buffalo, in Buffalo. Saw all of a sudden how things were run, said time's a waste and it's 19-1. Some men have everything and some have none, so rise and shine. In the USA, you can work your way to the head of the line.
Sing the line, ladies and gentlemen. Line forms here to meet the President of the United States. Sing the line to shake hands with President William McKinley.
Joel Gosh, quiet man, worked out a quiet and simple plan. Strolled of a morning all spick and span to the Temple of Music by the Tower of Light at the Pan American Exposition in Buffalo. In Buffalo. Saw Bill McKinley there in the sun. Heard Bill McKinley say, folks have fun. Some men have everything and some have none, but that's just fine. In the USA, you can work your way to the head of the line.
Big Bill
gave him a thrill.
Big Bill
sold him a bill.
Big Bill,
who'd want to kill a man of goodwill like
Big Bill?
Doesn't the president look marvelous, so round and prosperous?
Do you know what his favorite dish is? It was in the paper.
Beef!
I'm told in his spare time he enjoys collecting coins.
Joel Gosh, angry man, said, I will do what a poor man can. Yes, said, there's nowhere more fitting than in the Temple of Music by the Tower of Light, between the Fountain of Abundance and the Court of Lilies at the Great Pan American Exposition in Buffalo. In Buffalo. Wrapped him a handkerchief round his gun. Said nothing wrong about what I'd done. Some men have everything and some have none. That's my design. The idea wasn't mine alone, but mine. And that's the sign. In the USA, you can have your say. You can set your goals and seize the day. You're given the freedom to work your way to the head of the line. To the head of the line.